वरान्वयकरे
ओके वर्तते स्वेच्छा केसरिणः स्वच्छ स्वच्छाय आयासिते इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्ते छिदो नकाः। विल स्टार्ट लेट हर जॉइन।
ஸ்கூல் போன கிளாஸ் சில கிளாஸ்ல வந்து டவுட் இருக்கு கேட்கறது ஒரே ஸ்லோகம் மட்டும் அந்த ஒரே ஸ்லோகம் எதுன்னா
Is that Vyangya Vyanjaka Sambandha Nibandhana Taya Dvanihi?
இல்ல அந்த எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஸ்லோகம் எல்லாம் கொடுத்தாரு இல்லையா எப்படி வந்து நிஷேத வாச்சியத்துல விதி ரூப
பிரமதார்மிக
வரும் ஆமா அதுல வந்து அந்த விரஜ மம ஏவ ஏகஸ்யா பவ இல்ல இல்ல அது இல்ல சாரி இல்லையே அதுதான்
Okay, what is the doubt?
Shwasarodisi, adhuva. Sorry, one minute. Illa, illa, abhisari kaanam vignam karoshi. Adhu, prarthiye tavat prasida. Adhu, actually, vandhu, enakku, purila.
Prarthiye tavat prasida.
Adhu, vandhu, periya discussion pannaar liya. Avar, yaar, sakhi solraala, illa, nayakan solraana. Enakku, adhu, kadasila, avar, abhinavaguptar, enna solraana.
Oh, so what that is actually a pratishedha rupe vachye anubhaya rupaha vyangyaha dane the intent of that shloka is just very simple the vachyartham is pratishedha rupam adu modalla purinjindru apprama abhinavaguptarku pola vachyartha is pratishedha rupam garche prarthaye tavat prasida nivartasva
antadnala pratishedha
rupam so nivartasva just go back or do not do what you're doing do not go on the streets ena unnudaiya mukham vandu mukha shashi jyotsna vilupta tamonivahe our face is going to cause a problem for the other abhisarikas because it's so beautiful like the jyotsna adhaan ivana point so now what is he trying to say what is he trying to convey through the pratiyamana artham na anga da namakku vandu it is neither don't go nor does he say go It is anubhaya rupam. All he wants to say is, you are very beautiful. If you, and I would like to be with you. So why are you creating a situation where you are not going to be satisfied by this action of yours? அவ்வளவுதான் அதோட நிறுத்திக்கோ ஏன்னா பாக்கி எல்லாம் வந்து சகிருதயா ஏவ பிரமாணம் ரெலவென்ஸ் டு த டெக்ஸ்ட் அப்புறமா நம்ம வந்து டிஸ்கஷன் வச்சுக்கலாம் அபினவ குப்தர் வச்சுட்டேன் சரியா
சோ அவளோட சௌந்தர்யம் வந்து இங்க அதுதான் பிரதியமானமா இருக்கு
எஸ் அப்படின்னு எடுத்துக்கோ இங்க இப்ப சத்திக்கு கேவலம் ஆத்மனஹா விக்னம் ந கேவலம் ஆத்மனஹா விக்னம் கரோஷி லாகவாத் அபகுமான ஆஸ்பதம் அபி ஆத்மானம் குருவதி யூ ஆர் ஆல்சோ புட்டிங் யுவர் செல்ஃப் இன் அ டிஸ்ரெஸ்பெக்ட்ஃபுல் பொசிஷன் பை அப்ரோச்சிங் த நாயிகா ஆர் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஓன் அக்கார்ட் That is also a vengam here. So you can't say it is nivartasva, na nivartasva, iti pratishedha rupopi vengyaha nasti, vidhi rupopi vengyaha nasti. Nariya vengyangal varlaan. See, when the vachyarthatle irundhu, when you're looking at the pratiyamanartham, there can be varieties of pratiyamanartha for each and every person who is a sahridaya. How you view the whole shloka depends. And what you get from the shloka is different. Just like kasyavana bhavati rosho.
Nee, yanak illa finally vengyartham ay varmari nikkala yanak. Thirupi vero nivartaswala dhaan poi mudiyad. Yanak vandha andha problem irukku.
That it will take time for you to get to that. Adu appuram we will discuss that later. Pannuvom. Definitely baapom. Seri, I think we have to start from this section, yeah? Okay. Alankareshu dvanehe antarbhavasya nirasaha. So, parikara shlokaschatra vyangya vyanjaka sambandha nibandhanataya dvanehe vachya vachaka charutva hetu antapatita kutaha. We stopped with that shloka. Yeah. So, idu potuntenna enakku. It's easier to just read from there. Nanu yatra pratiyamanasya arthasya vaishadhyena apratitihi sa nama ma bhut dvanehe vishayaha. So where the suggested meaning vaishadhyena apratitihi, if it is not very clear. So yatra pratiyamanasya arthasya vaishadhyena apratitihi, if the pratiyamana or the suggested meaning is not very clear, sa nama vabhutu dvanehe vishayah, then it need not come under dvani, it need not be included in the dvani section. But if there is a pratiyamana artha, see, if you look at upama, if you look at upama alankaram, now we are only talking about how dvani cannot be included under upamana, because alankara is based on vachya and vachaka charutva hetu. Alankaras are those ornaments which beautify the vachyartha and the vachaka shabda, either the primary meaning or the primary word. That is that charutva hetu is called alankara. Now dvani does not depend completely on vachya vachaka, it can be completely different from vachya vachaka, like how we saw in Brahmadharmika or in that Prarthaye Tavat. So it is dependent on the suggested vyangya artha and the vyanjaka shabda. So vyangya vyanjaka sambandha nibandhanataya dvanehi. So in alankaras, if you take generally the gamut of alankara, you can have something which is pratiyamanam also. Tasya pratiyamanasya vaishadhyena sputataya apratitihi chet yatra pratiyamanarthayeva naspurati tatra dvanihi na mabhut. It's okay, I accept. Yatra tu pratitihi asti, he takes a list of alankaras where you have a beautiful suggested meaning also, like in samasokti, akshepa, anukta nimitta, visheshokti, पर्यायोक्तः अपन्नुति दीपक संकरालंकारादौ तत्र ध्वनेः अंतर्भावः भविष्यति इत्यादि निराकर्तुम् अभिहितम् उपसर्जनीकृतस्वार्थौ विफाउंड यत्रार्थ शब्दो वा उपसर्जनीकृतस्वार्थौ व्यंगकाव्य विशेषः सद्वनिरिति सूरिभिः कथितः. इन दैट कारिका वी सॉ द वर्ड उपसर्जनीकृतस्वार्थौ. Why does the shabda and artha upasarjanikritam means it becomes apradhanam, and then if the vyangyartha is more prominent, that is where it can be dhvani. Whereas in these alankaras, samasokti, akshepa, anukta nimitta, and in this list of alankaras, dhvanehe antarbhavaha bhavishyati, because there is a pratiyamanartha, there is a vachyartha, he's going to deal with each and every alankaram, and we will know how there is a vachyartha, there is a pratiyamanartha, and since there is a pratiyamanartha in samasokti or akshepa or anukta nimitta vish, any of these alankaras, dvani can be included in this list. Why do we have to give it a special place and talk about it as something unique? Why should it be a unique concept? Not necessary. It can be one of these alankaras. Maybe it cannot come under upama or rupakam. Rupaka and upama, there is no pratiyamanartha in a very unique manner or in a special manner. Whereas these alankaras, there is a pratiti, there is a pratiyamanartham, there is a suggested beauty to it, or there is a suggestion in it. In those alankaras where there is a suggestion, dvani can be included. That is the Purupakshi stand. That is the Abhavavadi stand. यथा समासोक्ति आक्षेपादि अलंकारादौ तत्र ध्वनेः अंतर्भावः भविष्यति इत्यादि निराकर्तुम्, इन ऑर्डर टू रिमूव दैट पॉसिबिलिटी दैट अ पूर्वपक्षी मे से उपसर्जनीकृत स्वार्थौ हैज बीन इंक्लूडेड इन द कारिका यत्रार्थ शब्दो वा उपसर्जनीकृत स्वार्थौ. व्हाट डज दैट मीन? Upasarjani krita swa artha. There are three words there, and Anandavardhana explains those three words by saying arthaha guni krita atma guni krita abideyaha shabdahava yatra arthantaram abhivyanakti sayeva dvanihi iti. This is the karika explanation for the 13th karika yatrata shabdava. This is the explanation for that. Arthaha गुणीकृत आत्मा उपसर्जनीकृत स्वार्थौ मीन्स गुणीकृत आत्मा यत्र अर्थस्य गुणीकरणं भवति अथवा अप्रधानत्वं भवति गुणीकृत अभिधेयः, अभिधेयः शब्दः, वाचकशब्दः, यत्र शब्दस्यापि अप्रधानत्वं विद्यते तादृश अर्थः शब्दो वा यत्र यस्मिन् काव्ये अर्थान्तरम् अभिव्यनक्ति, अर्थान्तरं प्रतीयमानार्थम् अभिव्यनक्ति व्यञ्जनाव्यापारेण अभिव्यनक्ति. इट् सजेस्ट्स् सम् अदर् ब्यूटिफुल् मीनिङ्ग् दट् अलोन् इस् काल्ड् ध्वनि. तेषु कथं तस्य अन्तर्भावः, तेषु इत्युक्ते समासोक्त्यादि अलङ्कारादिषु अथवा वाच्यवाचकचारुत्वहेतुषु कथं तस्य ध्वनेः अन्तर्भावः भविष्यति. व्यङ्ग्यप्राधान्ये हि ध्वनिः, सो व्यङ्ग्यप्राधान्ये हि ध्वनिः, ओन्ली वेन् द प्रतीयमानार्थ इस् प्रधान और् इम्पार्टेण्ट् दट् इस् वेर् ध्वनि अकर्स्. न च एतत् समासोक्त्यादिषु अस्ति, न च एतत् समासोक्त्यादिषु अस्ति मीन्स् एतत् व्यङ्ग्यस्य प्राधान्यं समासोक्त्यादिषु, समासोक्ति आक्षेप एक्सेट्रा दट् लिस्ट् आफ् अलङ्कारस् दट् यु सो दट् इन् दोस् अलङ्कारस् वी डु नाट् सी द प्रतीयमानार्थं टु बि इम्पार्टेण्ट्, वि ओन्ली सी दट् द प्रैमरि वर्ड् एण्ड् द मीनिङ्ग् इस् इम्पार्टेण्ट्. वाच्यार्थस्यैव प्राधान्येन समासोक्त्यादौ दृश्यते, प्राधान्यं दृश्यते, न तु व्यङ्ग्यार्थस्य प्राधान्यं दृश्यते. तस्मात् ध्वनिः समासोक्त्यादिषु अन्तर्भवितुं न अर्हति. ओके, सो ही टेक्स् अप् ईच् अण्ड् एव्री अलङ्कार अण्ड् पायिण्ट्स् औट् हौ इन् दीस् अलङ्कारस् वाच्यस्यैव प्राधान्यात् ध्वनेः अन्तर्भावः नास्ति. इट् केन ध्वनि केनाट् बि इन्क्लूडेड् अण्डर् अलङ्कारस्. दिस् इस् अ मेजर् टापिक्. सो द फस्ट् टापिक् दट् वि डेल्ट् वित् वास् द डिफरेण्ट् मिस्कन्सेप्शन्स् अबौट् ध्वनीस्. द नेक्स्ट् टापिक् इस् एस् एन् आन्सर् टु दि अभाववादि हि स्टार्ट्स् आफ् वित् हौ ध्वनि केनाट् बि इन्क्लूडेड् अण्डर् सर्टन् टैप्स् आफ् अर्थालङ्कारस्. Those certain types of alankaras, he lists or picks out only those alankaras where there is a possibility of a pratiyamanartha, but that pratiyamanartha does not have a prominence, it does not have pradhanyam. So the first example he takes, first alankaram that he deals with is, I didn't know that you couldn't see the screen till now. The first he deals with is upodharaga, the samasokti. Nacha etat samasokti adishu asti samasoktau tavat upodharagena vilolakarakam tatha grihitam shashina nishamukham yatha samastam timiramshukam taya puropiragat galitam nalakshitam. The idea of samasokti, first let's look at the lakshana and then go to this shlokam. So the lakshanam of samasokti, there are different alankarikas have given different lakshana definitions for this alankaram. So prakritarthena vakyena tat samanaihi visheshanaihi aprastuta arthakatanam samasoktir udakhrita. This is one alankarika's explanation. Kolyananda explanation is the simplest and the one that I like very much. Samasokti parispurtihi prastute aprastutasya cha. Prastute sati, when there is a contextual incident that is going on, contextual happening or a vishaya, aprastutasya parispurtihi yada bhavati. Aprastutasya, non-contextual thing, the image of a non-context comes to our mind, then it is samasokti. And he gives the example of I am indri mukham pashya raktastumbati chandramaha. We will come back to upodara again later. Let's first understand the alankaram. Samasokti is where you have a context being described, but with the description of that context, a non-contextual image arises in our mind. So the example here that Kovalanandakaras gives is, I am Aindri Mukham Pashya. Aindri Mukham, Indra Sammandhi, Aindri, Prachi Mukham. The eastern direction is called Aindri Mukham Pashya. Look at the east. Chandramaha, the moon, Raktaha Chandramaha, the red color moon, Chumbati, it is touching the face. Look at this moon, which is touching the face of the eastern direction. The words he uses, now we have to go to the earlier definition where he says, Prakritarthena Vakyena. with a contextual sentence, prakritarthena vakyena. What is the context here? The moon is rising. The moon is red in color. It is rising from the eastern direction. And it is touching the eastern direction. That's all we see. That is the context here. So, prakritena, prakritarthena vakyena. Tat samanaihi visheshanaihi. Each of the visheshana or the words that he has used have two meanings. Samana visheshanam. For the aprastutartha kathanam, the non-contextual story also has, can be, you can use the same words, same visheshana that are there for the context, can be applied for the non-context also. How is it applied? Mukham has two meanings. One is the direction, dik, aindri dik, ityukte prachi dik, mukham, iti vyavaharaha asti. दिशः मुखम् इति व्यवहारः अस्ति तथा मुखम् इत्युक्ते आननम् द फेस् इस् आल्सो इट् इस् अ पर्यायवाचि फार् बोत् दिक् एण्ड् फार् आननम् सो ऐन्द्री मुखम् इट् केन् गो फार् बोत् नायिकास् मुखम् एण्ड् फार् द प्राची मुखम् आर् द ईस्टर्न् डिरेक्षन् रक्तः इस् अनदर् वर्ड् विच् इस् बोत् अनुरागयुक्तः नायकः एण्ड् रक्तः रक्तवर्णयुक्तः चन्द्रमाः बोत् मीनिङ्ग्स् केन् अकर् देर् बिकास् आफ् द विशेषण विच् हाव् बोत् टु मीनिङ्ग्स् चुम्बति आल्सो चुम्बति इस् जस्ट् संयोगः इट् इस् जस्ट् दट् द मून् इस् टचिङ्ग् द ईस्टर्न् डिरेक्षन् आर् देर् इस् अ काण्टाक्ट् बिट्वीन् द ईस्टर्न् डिरेक्षन् एण्ड् द चन्द्र बट् द इमेज् दट् कम्स् टु अवर् मैण्ड् इस् यू वित् द यूस् आफ् द पुल्लिङ्ग स्त्रीलिङ्ग द वर्ड्स् मुखम् एण्ड् रक्त It is as if a Nayaka is trying to kiss the Nayika. That is the image that comes to our mind. That's your aprastutam. So, prakritarthena vakyena tat samanaihi. Now, you have a pratimanartha, you have a vachyartha. What is the vachyartham here? Which is the description of the moonrise. The pratimanartham is the Nayika Nayaka vrittantaha. That is your pratimanam. Okay? Why it can even be considered for a dhvani. For that, we have to look at the lakshanam and the udaharanam. Now, the udaharanam that Anandavardhana gives is upodaragena ilolatarakam tathagrihitam shashina nishamukham. Upodaragena shashina. Combine all the tritiya vibhaktis together and then combine the tritiya vibhakti with the nishamukham. So, upodaragena shashina. The same meaning of Aindri Mukham Pashya Raktas Chumbati Chandramaha is going to be is described even in a more beautiful manner here. So Upodharagena with the colorful, you know, the Shashi is Chandra, the moon has a red color with him. So Upodharagena Shashina Raktavarna Yuktaha Chandraha Tena Nisha Mukham Grihitam. The face of the night has been taken. So here the direction, that is the entire night has been, it has been taken by the moon, or the moon has shown its presence during the night. How is the night here? Vilola Tarakam, the stars are all shining. Vilola means it is Sanchalam. Sanchala Tarakani Vartanti Taraha. So the Nisha, the in the night it has twinkling stars. It's going to be two meanings again. We will go with that. So the Nisha Mukham, the adjective for Nisha Mukham is Vilola Tarakam. With the twinkling stars, the night is there. Tatha Grihitam, the Nisha Mukham, the night has been taken forth, or it has been captured by the moon in such a manner that Yatha Grihitam. Tatha grihitam yatha samastam timira amshukam. It's the darkness that is there in the night has completely gone away. Puro galitam, but it was not noticed by the night. As soon as the moon rose during the night, the entire darkness just moved away and the night did not even notice that. The words he uses here are Timira Amshukam Galitam. Samastam Timira Amshukam. Amshuka is the cloth. So the cloth which is what is the upper cloth for a night, which is the Thimiram. The darkness is like an upper cloth for the night, and it fell off from her body and she did not even notice. So it is like how a Nayika, when a Nayaka, when the Kamuka or her beloved comes and embraces her or just grabs her, or touches her face, lifts her face, and she doesn't even notice that her upper cloth has slipped away. Bragat, because she is so much in love with that Nayika, she does not even notice that. But that is the image that comes to our mind because of the words that he uses here. What are the words? Upoda ragena, anuraga yuktena, shashina, chandrena, nisha mukham, vilola tarakam. Here, vilola tarakam is both taraka also means the pupil of the pupil. Eye pupil is also taraka, which is sanchala yuktam. So, Nayika, who is lajja mukta Nayika, her eyes will keep moving up and down. She won't be able to look at the Nayika steadfastly. She is not proudha in her love. She is just fallen in love with this person. So she is sanchala yukta taraka tarakam. The pupils of her eyes are moving this way and that way. So the samastam timira amshukam galitam ragat na lakshitam. She did not even notice that. So ityadav, in this samasokti, vyangena anugatam vachyameva pradhanyam. Someone is describing the moonrise and how the darkness has moved away from the night. And there is only that Chandra Prakashaha that is there. The Prakritam is only that. The Nayika Nayaka Vyavahara has been superimposed here on both the Nisha and Shashi. Shashi is a Pullinga word. Nisha is a Strilinga word. So the idea of a Nayika and a Nayaka Vyavahara, the behavior of a beloved has been superimposed here, and that superimposition cannot stand without these words. We come back to how beautifully the scene has been described in front of us. It is just the moon has risen. That's all has to be described. But the way he has described it, You think of the Nayika Nayaka Vrittanta, but that Nayika Nayaka Vrittantam is not Pradhanam. Even though there is a Vyangya there. Vyangyena Anugatam Vachyameva Pradhanyena Pratiyate. Only the primary meaning has importance here because it is, after all, the nature description. There is no importance for the Vyangyartham here. Whereas in all the other shlokas that we saw, Kasivana Bhavati Rosho, Drishtva Priyayaha Saprana Madaram, the Vyangyartham is more important. She, the Sakhi, wishes to convey to that Kamuka that do not be with her in such a manner that you give her a wound, and a noticeable wound. She is trying to tell us that, Sakhi is trying to tell us that, she is clever. That Sakhi is so clever that she is able to protect her friend. She is telling her friend that. So the Vyangyartham is much more important than the Vachyartha. Here it is only the description of the nature that is important. So in Samasokti, we come back to the Vachyartham. Vyangyena Anugatam Vachyam. The Vachyartha, or the primary meaning, which is followed by the Vyangyartha. But the Vachyameva Pradhanyena Pratiyate. It is only the primary meaning that shines forth in an important manner. Samaropita superimposed Nayika Nayaka Vyavaharayoho Nisha Shashinoho Eva Vakyarthatvat. The Vakyartha, because of the use of the words Mukham, Amshukam, Galitam. See, you never say Timiram Galitam. The darkness has slipped away. The slipping away is more of a characteristic of a Vastram and not of darkness. The darkness has been removed, destroyed, you can say. But it just, the usage of those words are, you want that Nayika Nayaka Vyavahara being superimposed on Shashi and Nisha. Tasyapi Vakyarthatvat. So it becomes expressed here. Okay? Puriyada?
இங்க வாக்கியார்த்தம் ஈக்குவல்ஸ் வாச்சியார்த்தமா?
Yes.
வாக்கியார்த்தா ஈக்குவல்ஸ் வாச்சியார்த்தா.
Vachyartham. It is the meaning of the sentence as such. அவ்வளவுதான். வாச்சியார்த்தம் தான் பிரைமரி மீனிங்கா போயிடுறது உனக்கு. ஓகேயா? நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் ஆக்ஷேபே வாச்சிய பிராதான்யம் இத்தியாதோ வெங்கேன அனுகதம். ஆக்ஷேபே அப்படி வெங்கிய விசேஷ ஆக்ஷேபிணா அப்படி வாச்சியசைவ சாருத்வம் பிராதான்யேன வாக்கியார்த்தா ஆக்ஷேபோக்தி சாமர்த்தியாதேவ ஞாயதே ததாஹி தத்ர சப்தோபரூடா விசேஷ அபிதான இச்சையா பிரதிஷேத ரூபா யா ஆக்ஷேபா சயேவ வியங்கிய விசேஷம் ஆக்ஷிபன்னு முக்கியம் காவிய சரீரம். த லக்ஷணம் ஆஃப் ஆக்ஷேபாலங்கார இஸ் பிரதிஷேதா இவ இஷ்ட இஷ்டஸ்ய யோ விசேஷ அபிதிச்சயா வக்ஷமாண உக்த விஷயா ச ஆக்ஷேபா த்விதா மதா. ஆக்ஷேப இஸ் ஆஃப் டூ டைப்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் இஷ்டஸ்ய பிரதிஷேதா விசேஷ அபிதிச்சயா. இன் ஆர்டர் டு கன்வே சம்திங் பர்டிகுலர் ஆர் யூனிக் ஸ்பெசிபிக், இன் ஆர்டர் டு கன்வே சம்திங் ஸ்பெசிபிக் யூ ஆர் நெகேட்டிங் சம்திங் தட் இஸ் டிசைர்ட். ஐதர் சம்திங் தட் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு சே ஆர் சம்திங் தட் இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி பீன் செட். your pratishedah or your negating something that you are going to say vakshyamanasya pratishedah athava ukta visheshasyaiva pratishedah. So there can be two types. Now the example he gives here is of the vakshyamana visheshasya pratishedah eva atra. In the Lochanam, he gives two examples for that. We will not go too much into those examples. Let's look at what Anandavardhana says. Anuragavati sandhya divasastat purassaraha aho daivagati kidrika tathapina samagamaha. I think this is Panini's shlokam. This is a Panini shloka, right? Panini has written this. These are all some of the small shlokas that you find in different texts, which people have quoted it as Panini shloka. So anuragavati sandhya, sandhya the dusk or the dawn, both of that, divasaha tat purassaraha, the day time is or the sun or day time is just in front of it. Tat purassaraha sandhya, sandhya is the sandhya kalam. Sandhya kalaha, if you use sandhya kalaha, then it becomes pullinga shabda. So he very cleverly, very beautifully, he uses the word sandhya as a, in strilingam, and she says anuragavati. She is very red in color. Raktavarna yukta sandhya athava anuraga yukta. So anuraga has two meanings, the shlesha. Here anuragavati sandhya divasaha tatpurasaraha. Divasaha, the daytime is just in front of her, either before or after. If you are talking of dawn, sandhya anuragavati asti tatpurasaraha, the day is going to come in front of her or is just near her. Aho daivagatihi kidrika. Look at the fate, the lines of fate is such that tathapina samagamaha, there is no union between the sandhya and divasaha. The daytime and the dusk can never join together, even though they are right in front of each other, right near, next to each other. But you can never say there exists a point where dawn and daytime or dusk and daytime are together. Samanadhikaranyam. So, daivagatihi kidrika. This gives us an idea, of course, of a nayika or nayaka, or someone is saying, you know, see, she is so much in love with that nayaka. The nayaka is also present there. But the fate is such that they are never able to meet. So that is the idea, but the beauty exists in the expression of this. See, the dawn and dusk, the dusk or the sandhya divasaha cha samipavartinaha eva. So they both are together eva. You know, they're not together, they are near each other, but they are not able to join together. Tathapi samagamaha na bhavati iti daivagatihi kidrika. Aho, that is the turn of fate. ஆக்ஷேபே வியங்கிய விசேஷ ஆக்ஷேபிணா அபி வாச்சியஸ்ய. நவ் திஸ் இஸ் த வாச்சியார்த்தம். வாட் இஸ் த வாச்சியார்த்தம்? அனுராகவதி சந்தியா, சந்தியா காலஹா அனுராக யுக்தஹா அஸ்தி திவசஹா தத் புரஸ்ஸரஹா ததாபி தேஷாம் சமாகம தயோஹோ சமாகமஹா ந பவதி இத்தியேவ வாச்சியார்த்தஹ. தஸ்ய சாருத்வம் கதம் பவதி வியங்கிய ஆக்ஷேபிணா. சோ இட் கிவ்ஸ் அ, நவ் இட் கிவ்ஸ் அ வியங்கியார்த்த. ஆக்ஷேபா மீன்ஸ் இட் சஜஸ்ட்ஸ் அ வியங்கிய விசேஷம். A suggested meaning is being indicated here. Akshepinaha by the vachyartha. Vachyasyaiva charutvam pradhanyam. See, those two are always nearby, but they don't meet each other. There is no beauty in that vyangyartha. Whereas the vachyartham has more beauty and it is pradhana, it is important. Vachyasyaiva charutvam pradhanyam. பிராதான்யேன, பிகாஸ் வாச்சியஸ்யைவ சாருத்வம் பிராதான்யேன, வாச்சியஸ்ய பிராதான்யேன வாச்சியஸ்யைவ சாருத்வம் ததா வாக்கியார்த்தஹ ஆக்ஷேபோக்தி சாமர்த்யாதேவ ஞாயதே. ஆக்ஷேப உக்தி, பிகாஸ் வாட் இஸ் த வாக்கியார்த்தம் மீன்ஸ் ஹியர் த தாத்பர்யார்த்தம், the tatparyam or the what do we understand from this entire shlokam, why has the poet said the shloka? Maybe to indicate, you know, even if things are at your hand's reach, you still won't be able to get it. That fatalistic attitude is what the poet is trying to convey. That tatparyartham is only because of the akshepa ukti. It is only, we understand that because of the vachyartham, because of the, you know, indicatory words that are there in the vachya. Tathahi tatra shabda uparudaha. By the force of the words, Vishesha Abhidana Ichchaya Pratisheda Rupaha Yaha Akshepaha Sayeva Vyangya Vishesham Mukhyam Kavya Shariram Vyangya Vishesham Akshipanna. Shabdoparudaha Vishesha Abhidana Ichchaya. When this, when it wants to convey, sorry, Vishesha Abhidana Ichchaya, in order to convey something particular, Shabda Uparudaha Pratisheda Rupaha Si Tatapi Na Samagamaha, that is the Pratisheda Rupa that is being said in the words. So Shabda Uparudaha Pratisheda Rupaha, that is the Akshepa here. Sayeva Vyangya Vishesham, and the Vyangya that we understand is, we are not, you know, something that is at hand is not able to, you are not able to get it. You, maybe the upameyamtvam is the akshepam here, or the vyangyam, what we want to convey, or the tatparyartham, which is the vyangya vishesham. That is akshipanna mukhyam shariram. Yad shabda uparodaha eva mukhyam kavya shariram. So the kavya shariram, what is kavya shariram? Shabda and artha are the kavya shariram. That is mukhyam here. Okay, vyangya vishesham akshipanna. Even though it suggests a vyangyartha, the shabda and the artha that is being used, aho devagati kidrika tathapina samagamaha or anuragavati sandhya, all of these words are much more important than the vyangyartha that is tries to indicate to us. Atra satyam api vyangya pratitau. In this shloka, even though there is a suggested meaning, vachyasyaiva charutvam Utkarshavat, because it has a pradhanyam, because it is more beautiful, the vachyarthasyaiva tasyaiva pradhanya vivaksha. Only in akshepalankaram, it is only the vachyartha that has importance. Okay, next tick polama.
Next, actually I think ava vandu time tappa maatha marandutaan nenikiren.
நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் தீபகம். So, yatha cha deepaka apannuthau. Now, actually, in that list of alankaras that he said before, if you looked at it, samasokti, akshepa, the next is actually anukta nimitta visheshokti. But suddenly, because he said akshepa, this deepakam and apannuti also seem like akshepa. So, he quickly talks about those two alankaras, and then he will again bring that in a one-liner at the end. So let's look at Deepaka and Apannuti first. Even though in the list it is actually Anukta Nimitta, but Ananda Vardhana remembers the Deepaka and Apannuti alankara based on Akshepa alankara. So yathacha Deepaka Apannutyado Vyangyatvena Upamayaha Pratitau Api Pradhanyena अविवक्षितत्वात् न तया व्यपदेशः तद्वत् अत्रापि द्रष्टव्यम्. Here that is all he has given, but I've taken examples from the lochanam here. Yada deepaka apannutyado, in deepaka alankara and apannutya alankara, vyangyatvena upamayaah pratito, we understand upama alankara through vyangya. In most of the alankaras, if you see it is based on upama. So he says upama shailushi iva, upamaika shailushi samprapta chitrabhumika vedane ranjayati kavyarange nrityanti tadvidam chetaha. This is a shloka given by Apedikshita in Chitramimamsa. See, upama is like a base alankaram. You are comparing two objects. There is something that is a standard of comparison, like a moon or the lotus or anything. And you have the Nayika's face, which you are comparing with, or the Nayaka's face. Both you are saying that this face is like the lotus. So the Kamalam becomes the Upamanam. You can express it in so many different ways. You can say your face is the lotus, which is the Rupakalankara. But you are actually comparing upama, you are comparing the two objects. You are saying that the face is so beautiful like the kamalam. There is a mridutvam, there is a saundaryam, it is got a pinkish color like the lotus. You can compare it with so many different dharma, sadharana dharmam between the two. So in Deepaka Alankara also, you are comparing two objects, and there is a sadharana dharma. Comparison itself is your base, and the way you compare is different. I can say, you know, what I see in front of me is not the Nayika Mukham. Athava, you look at the Chandraha and say, I am na Chandraha, I am tu Prayasi, idam tu Prayasi Mukham. I am na Chandraha, idam Prayasi Mukham. I can say, this is not the moon, it is my beloved's face. That is a different way of expression, but the underlying thing is Upama. So that's when Apedikshita says, Upama Shailushi Eva. She is like, Upama is like an actress who takes on different roles. As and when the role demands it, she changes her appearance, she changes her acting skills, all her actions and all are different. Her Vesha Bhusham is also different. The same way, Upama is the underlying Alankara. So, Yathacha, Deepaka Apannutyado, Vyangyatvena. As a suggestion, you understand upama. So upama yaha pratitau api. Even though upama is known through suggestion, pradhanyena avyakshitatvat, it is not the most, the upama is not important there. The way you express that is more important. So na taya vyapadeshaha. We don't, even though in alankaras like Deepakam and Apannuti, there is upama alankara, we do not mention it saying it is upama alankara, or we don't say, Atra upama alankara dvanihi vartate, iti vyapadeshaha na vidyate, kutaha pradhanyena vyapadeshaha bhavanti. Whichever is important, we only make a mention of that. If dvani is important in that shloka, then we say it is a dvani shloka. We don't say it is an example of alankara. If the alankara is important, then the pradhanyena vyapadeshaha, atra alankarasiva pradhanyate, alankaraha atra vidyate iti vyapadeshaha asti. We don't say it is a dvani shloka. So Deepaka example, the lakshanam is sakrit vrittistu dharmasya prakrita aprakritatmanam saiva kriya bahvishu One minute. Okay. Oh, this is Apannutiya. Deepakam. Sakrit vrittistu dharmasya prakrita aprakritatmanam. There is a contextual set of objects, non-contextual set of objects. Kriyasu bahveshu kriyasu karakasya va deepakam. When we sakrit vrittihi, either there are many different kriya and there is one common thing that connects all the prakritam and the aprakritam. You take a list of non-contextual things, take a list of contextual things. There is a commonality between the two, either using a karakam or using a kriya, using several kriya. So the all the prakritam can be in one kriya, all the aprakritam can be in one kriya, or prakritam and aprakritam can have the same karakam, and that can be the commonality here. Udaharanam, sanjahara sharatkalaha, kadamba kusumashriyaha, preyo viyogini namcha, nishesha sukha sampadaha. Sharatkalaha kadamba kusumashriyaha sanjahara tatha preyo viyogini nam nishesha sukha sampadaha api sanjahara. Atra kriyaya, you are connecting both the prakritam and the aprakritam. Let's say the prakritam is, you want to describe the sharatkala or the autumn season, which is your contextual. So sharatkalaha, the context is your sharatkala. What does it do? It removes the beauty of the kadamba flowers. Kadamba kusuma shriyaha sanjahara. It removes the beauty, that is, the flowers no longer bloom and they are no longer beautiful. So kadamba pushpanam saundaryam sharatkalaha harati. Yatha harati tatha eva preyo viyogininam nishesha sukha sampadaha api harati. Preyo viyogininam. Priyajanaha viyogina. So the those who are all in separated from their lovers, or they are going to be separated, viyogini nam sukham api harati sharatkalaha nishesha sukha sampadaha. It removes the happiness of all the people who are now separated from their lovers. So preyo viyoga karanat viyogini nam sukham api sharatkalaha harati. Maybe during autumn season, the beloveds just go for, they go on journeys. And that is why it says that it removes if it is spring season, then they know that they are going to be joined with their lovers and they are happy about it. During autumn season, those who are separated from their lovers are not going to feel happy. They're neither going, at least some nice things in the air can make them happy. That also they will not be feeling now. So sharatkalaha kadamba kusumashriyaha. Now what is the comparison here? Just as how the autumn season removes the beauty of the flowers, in the same manner it also removes the happiness of the ladies who are suffering. Virahinam api sukham harati. Atra harana kriya samana. Upama pratitihi api vidyate. So this here, you don't have eva. Sharatkalaha sanjahara eva. Yatha kusumanam shriyam harati. Tatha virahinam sukham api harati. Iti yatha tatha upayogena upamayaha pratitihi vachyaha bhavati. Kintu atra yatha tatha upayogaha nasti. Tasmadu upamayaha pratitireva asti. So it is suggested. Now that suggestion, you can't take it as dhvani. Why? Because the pradhanyam is not for upama. It removes the beauty and it removes the sukham. The expression of removing this and that has more importance than that upama pratiti. Tasmat na taya vyapadeshaha, taya upamaya vyapadeshaha na kriyate. Go back to the sentence in the text. Yataja deepaka apannutyadav vyangyatvena upamayaha pratitav api pradhanyena avivakshitatvat. Kasyaha upamayaha pradhanyena avivakshitatvat. Upamayaha pradhanyam na vivakshitam tatra. Deepakasyaiva pradhanyam vartate. Tasmat na taya vyapadeshaha upamaya vyapadeshaha nasti. Vyapadeshaha means shabdaya uktihi, shabdena uktihi na vidyate. तद्वत् इन् द सेम् मेनर् दीपकवत् अत्रापि ध्वनिविषये इवन् इन् ध्वनि इफ् देर् इस् अन् अलङ्कार देन् इफ् दि अलङ्कार हेस् प्रामिनेन्स् देन् ओन्लि इट् इस् द श्लोक इस् ओन्लि इण्डिकेटेड् एस् अन् अलङ्कार एक्साम्पल् एण्ड् नाट् एस् अ ध्वनि एक्साम्पल् सो अलङ्कारे तद्वत् अत्रापि द्रष्टव्यं मीन्स् अलङ्कारे कदापि ध्वनिशब्देन व्यपदेशः न भवति यतः ध्वनेः प्राधान्यं नास्ति कुत्र यत्र काव्ये अलङ्कारः विद्यते द सेम् गोस् टु अपन्नुति इन् द स्टेट्मेण्ट् हि यूसस् दीपक अपन्नुत्यादौ सो लेट्स् लुक् एट् एन् एक्साम्पल् आफ् अपन्नुति आल्सो प्रकृतं निषिध्य अन्यस्थापनम् अपन्नुतिः ओके डौट् रिका प्रकृतं निषिध्य अन्यस्थापनम् अपन्नुतिः दि एक्साम्पल् नेयं विरौति बृङ्गाली मदेन मुखरां मुहुः अयम् आकृष्यमाणस्य कन्दर्पधनुषः ध्वनिः बृङ्गाली इयं बृङ्गाली न विरौति मदेन मुखराः मुहुः मदेन मुखराः मुहुः दिस् इस् नाट् A kavi is looking at, you know, the group of bees which are all making a sound, mukaraha. They are being noisy here. Ayam bringali navirauti, iyam bringali navirauti. This is not a bringa samoham or, you know, madhukara samohaha atra navirauti, gunjanam nakaroti na gunjati. Ayam kandarpa dhanushaha, madanasya dhanushaha, ध्वनिः आकृष्यमाणस्य मदनस्य मदनधनुषः ध्वनिः दिस् इस् एक्चुलि द सौण्ड् आफ् द मन्मथस् बो विच् इस् बीङ्ग् पुल्ड् इट् इस् नाट् द सौण्ड् आफ् बीस् सो यु आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् बीस् विच् आर् आल् हम्मिङ्ग् हियर् एण्ड् यु आर् नेगेटिङ्ग् दट् सौण्ड् प्रकृतं निषिध्य यु आर् नेगेटिङ्ग् दट् सौण्ड् अन्यस्थापनं यु आर् superimposing or establishing another idea there. What is it that you are negating? Bringali, mukharam, gunjanam, atra, nishidhya, upamana bhutasya, manmata dhanushaha, dhvanihi, atra, sthapyate. In other words, you are saying the humming of the bees is equal to or it is comparable to the sound of manmatha dhanus so bringali kama dhanus you are comparing those two which means there is an upama pratiti even in apannuti alankara but taya vyapade pradhanyena avivakshitatvat upama alankarasya pradhanyena vivaksha na vartate atra tasmat upama alankaraha iti upama alankara shabdena atra vyapadeshaha na kriyate suchana na kriyate tadvat in the same manner so just like how in apannuti alankara you have the suggestion of an upama alankara but you do not say that it is an upama alankara dhvani you only say it is an apannuti alankara sthala in the same manner alankare api vachya vachaka charutva hetushu antarbhavaha dhvanehe na bhavati okay now he goes back to his list of samasokti akshepa and then anukta nimittam now visheshokti is actually sati hetau phala abhavah visheshoktihi nigadyate it's very simple alankara the converse of it or the opposite of it is karana abhave phala bhavah phala sattvam that is vibhavana now we are looking at only visheshokti visheshokti is sati pushkale karane there are a lot of reasons for an action to happen or for the success or a fruit for the result even then the result is absent phalasya abhavah yatra vidyate tatra visheshoktih here the reason for reason may be mentioned or the reason may not be mentioned If the reason is mentioned, then it becomes vachyam or it is being expressed. If the reason is not mentioned, anukta nimitta. If the reason is not mentioned, then the reason is being imagined or it is being suggested by the shlokam. ஸ்லோகா ஹியர் இஸ் ஆஹூதோபி சஹாயைஹி ஓம் இதி உக்த்வா விமுக்த நித்ரஹா அபி கந்துமனாஹ அபி பதிகா சங்கோச்சம் நைவ சிதிலயதி. கஷ்டித் பதிகா ஸ்வபிதி, ஹி இஸ் நாட் ஃபுல்லி ஸ்லீப்பிங், ஹி இஸ் விமுக்த நித்ரஹா, ஹி இஸ் சாரி, ஹி இஸ் ஸ்லீப்பிங் தேர், ஹி இஸ், ஹி ஹாஸ் டு லீவ் on his journey, he has continue, he has to continue his journey now. There is no, this is the context that we know. We can bring about n number of contexts or suggestions based on afterwards. So first let's look at this. Patikaha ekaha sahayehi ahutaha, his friends who are all traveling with him are calling him, get up, let's go. So ahutaha api, even though he is being called by his friends sahayehi. Now what does he say? He also says, okay, I will come. Om iti uktva, after saying yes, vimukta nitraha api, he has let go of his sleep, he is no longer sleeping, he has woken up, but not gotten up, he has woken up. Vimukta nitraha, his sleep has gone. Gantu manaha api, he wants to go, he wants to follow them, he wants to travel now. Gantu manaha api patikaha, a traveler, sankocham naiva shithilati, you know, sankocham is the posture in which you sleep, sankuch, you know, contract all your limbs and then you sleep, maybe because of shaityam or just the mere posture of sleeping. Patikaha saha sankocham, his posture of sleeping, naiva shithilati, he does not let go of that posture. See, if you want to go, you have to stretch, get up and go, right? But he wants to go, he is no longer sleeping, he is called by his traveler. So all those people who come with him, sahayehi mitraha mitrani, so all those friends also are calling him. Om iti uktva, he says yes, I will go, but still he does not get up and go. Now here nimittam na uktam atra sati heto, all of the reasons are present, but he does not let go of his posture and get up and go. Now what is the reason for that? That is not said in the shlokam. Nimittam karanam tu atra anuktam ityado vyangyasya prakarana samarthyat pratiti matram. So prakarana samarthyat means you are looking at the context. So let's look at one context. Maybe it is very cold, he is in a cozy posture, he has a blanket on him, he doesn't want to let go of that posture. So gantumanaha api, then that could be one of the reasons. So shaitya karanam prakarana vashate eva vyangyam bhasate. Now or he could have been dreaming about some priya, some beloved priya swapnam anudhyayamanatvat, anudhyayamanatvat anu paschat dhyayati. So he has dreamt about his beloved. So he just wants to, relive that or just continue with that in his own fashion. Sometimes it happens, right? If it's a very pleasant dream, you want to continue in that, you want to be in that and enjoy it for some more, savor that moment for some more time. So that could also be a reason. All of these reasons only come about in the Vyangyam. But that Vyangyam is according to the Prakarana Vasham, and it will be very clear also, but that is not Pradhanam here. So Prakarana Samarthyat Vyangyasya Pratiti Matram, it is very clear if the context is clear. Once I give you the context, then it is very easy for you to understand the Vyangyam. That Vyangyam is not Pradhanam. Natu Tat Pratiti Nimitta Kachit Charutva Nishpattihi. Oh, because of cold, he doesn't want to get up. That because of cold, shaitya karanam iti vyangyam, is not charutvam. It is not beautiful here. Saundaryam na avahati. It does not give us some beautiful, no, he's so cold. That doesn't have a meaning here. That doesn't have a beauty here. People are calling him. He says yes. He's let go of his sleep. He wants to go. Yet, he does not let go of his posture. That has more beauty than the vyangyartha. Iti na pradhanyam, vyangyasya pradhanyam na bhavati. Vyangyasya pratiti matrameva, kachit charutva nishpattihi nasti, tasmat vyangyasya na pradhanyam. Okay? So with this, his Uktanimitta Visheshokti is done. Next is Paryayoktam. Time aadithala. We'll stop with this.
இந்த இடத்துல தத் பிரதீதி நிமித்தான்றது வியங்கியஸ்ய பிரதீதி நிமித்தா
எந்த இடத்துல தத் பிரதீதி
அந்த விருத்தியில நது தத் பிரதீதி நிமித்தா
எஸ் தத் பிரதீதி வியங்கியஸ்ய பிரதீதி நிமித்தா காச்சித் சாருத்வ நிஷ்பத்தி நாஸ்தி அந்த வியங்கத்தினால வரக்கூடிய ஒரு இது வியங்கத்துக்கு ஒரு சாருத்வம் கிடையாது அவ்வளவுதான் ஓகே வில் ஸ்டாப் வித் திஸ் நாஸ்தே